Hello, Year 4. It's Mrs. Plews here with your RE lesson for Thursday, the 26th of November. Let's have a look at what we're doing today. Okay, just before we begin then, at the beginning of our RE lessons, we like to quieten our minds, don't we? So just give yourself a moment. You might have had a busy morning, working really hard on your home learning. So just take a moment for yourself and focus on your breathing and just calm your body and your mind. Okay, we're actually beginning our new unit of work today. So this Sunday marks the beginning of the season of Advent in the liturgical calendar. So we're going to be beginning our Advent work today to start thinking about what that means. So I'm going to begin by playing a reflection video, which will introduce the idea of Advent to you. While you watch the video, I'd like you to think, what does Advent mean? Why is this a special time for Catholics? And what does Advent mean to you? So maybe think of some of the things that you do during Advent. Okay, I'll play the video to you now.
Kneel down, know my ground.
Okay, I hope that video helps you to think about Advent then and what Advent means. And hopefully you realise in the video, Advent's the time when we're waiting for Jesus to come at Christmas, but not just for his birth, we're waiting for his second coming also, okay, because we believe that he will come again. So during Advent, we're waiting and preparing for Jesus' coming. You might also know that the liturgical colour we associate with Advent is purple, and you'll see that on our prayer areas when we return to school next week, okay? So let's have a look at our walk for today. So for our first lesson, we're going to be giving reasons for the symbols used on the Jesse tree. I imagine that's the first time some of you have heard that phrase, Jesse tree. So we're going to find out what a Jesse tree is today. There's a picture there to give you a clue. Okay, looking at our target sheet, and we'll glue these into our books when we return to school next week, we're going to be working on this second target here, so explaining the purpose of the Jesse tree in helping Christians prepare for Advent and to recognise and describe some of the symbols on it. Okay, so let's begin thinking about Advent then. I wonder if you can add any I wonder questions to our Advent title here. So I've added one that I was thinking about. I wonder if Advent always begins on the same date every year. So we know it's beginning this Sunday. Does it always begin on the 29th of November, or is it different dates each year? So that's one of my I wonder questions. Take a moment for yourself now. You might want to jot down any I wonder questions, or just keep them in your mind and think if you've got any I wonder questions about Advent. I know we can't discuss it together now, but perhaps you'd like to share them with me when we return to school next week. Okay, here's a Jesse tree then. So what is a Jesse tree? Here's a picture of a Jesse tree there. So what do you think the Jesse tree is? How might it be used? I'll just give you a moment to think. If you look at the pictures on there, that will give you some clues, because the pictures actually represent people. That's a bit of a clue there to help you. So take a moment to have a look at those pictures in the tree. What do you think the Jesse tree is showing, and how might it be used? So I've already told you that the symbols represent people, but why do you think they represent people, and maybe which people do you think they represent? Again, take a moment for yourself to think there, and then we'll have a look together in a minute. So a Jesse tree is Jesus's family tree. A family tree is a diagram showing the relationship between people in several generations of a family. So this is just an example of a family tree. So you might have your grandparents, then your mum and dad, you and your siblings, but also linked to your parents, you'll have their siblings, so your aunts and uncles and your cousins, their children, okay? A Jesse tree is very special to Catholics, as it is meant to tell the story of how God interacts with his people and not just who is related to them. So the idea is it's telling stories about the people on the tree. A Jesse tree is meant to be used during Advent. It is a way of preparing for the coming of Jesus into our world. At the beginning of Matthew's Gospel, there is a very long list of the ancestors of Jesus. A lot of the names on the list are actually Jewish prophets. These prophets talked about the coming of the Messiah and what we needed to do to get ready for his coming. So the Messiah is a name that we give to Jesus, and it means the one who was promised to us. So God promised that he would send his son to us, and Jesus is that son. Okay, so some more pictures of Jesse trees there for you to see. The Jesse tree is a way of remembering these prophets, of how they lived and of how they asked people to change. It is a reminder that we too need to do something to get ready for Jesus. We too need to change. Each day, Christians hang one symbol on the tree and remember the life of the person. So this is something that we can do throughout Advent to help us think about those special people in Jesus' life and think about the important things that they did and what we can learn from them. That might help us to make changes in our own lives. Perhaps there's things we think we could do better at, or things we think we shouldn't do. And we can learn from the example of those people. So let's have a go. Can we name any of the ancestors of Jesus? So look carefully at the pictures there. If you think through some of the stories we might have discussed in school or you might have heard in church, think of any of those pictures, remind you of anyone from the stories that you might have heard. We're going to name a few of them together, and then you will have a go at some of them in your work today. So I'm just looking here. Now, right at the top of the tree, so kind of at the start of the family tree, there's a picture of a world and an apple. And I know in the story of Adam and Eve, Eve actually ate an apple that she wasn't supposed to eat in the Garden of Eden. So I think I'm going to link Adam and Eve with those symbols there. Okay, let me see if there are any others I recognize. Ah, I'm just thinking back to our work on Judaism. And here I can see the Ten Commandments. And I remember that when we learned about the Ten Commandments, we found out that God gave the Ten Commandments to Moses. So I think that one might be representing Moses. Put him on there. Right, now Joseph. Let me think. Well, Joseph, actually, he had lots of brothers, didn't he? And there's the story of Joseph and his amazing Technicolor dream coat. So I think this is going to be Joseph there. He had a coat of many colours, if you remember. That coat looks really special to me, so I think that's probably Joseph there. And there's a picture of a whale here. I know a story about Jonah and the whale, so I think that could be Jonah. Ah, crown here. Well, a crown is worn by a king or a queen, isn't it? So that's probably King David. Okay, so hopefully you see how I'm using stories that I've heard in church or read in the Bible or heard in our lessons to help me try and identify some of those people on the Jesse tree. So your task today, you've got this sheet that I've put onto your daily plan for today for you. What I'd like you to do is decide who is represented by each of those symbols in the pictures and give me a reason. So when we were just doing that together then, you heard me saying, I knew that Eve had eaten an apple in the Garden of Eden. So that would be my reason for why I think that is Eve. Okay, so the names that you're going to be linking with those pictures, there's eight of them. So you've got Moses. Now there's two Josephs here. So we've got Joseph, who's Jesus's father. So think what you know about him. In particular, think what he did for his job. Okay, so he wasn't just Jesus's father. He actually did something for a job. So think what he did. We've got Noah. So you'll probably know a story of Noah to do with some lots and lots of animals. So that might help you. Joseph, we already talked about. So we know he had that special coat. King David, we've talked about. Adam and Eve, we've already talked about. Abraham. Now we did talk about Abraham in our prayer, saints and feast work. So if you remember, Abraham had two sons. Think back to that story. And think which religion Abraham was really important in as well. And then we've got Mary, Jesus's mother. Okay, so think how she might be represented to show how special she was. Okay, so this is the worksheet that you've got. You'll put the names on of the prophets that you match to the symbols and then give me a reason for them. If you don't have a printer at home, don't worry. You can always draw the pictures and write for us in your book. Okay, you don't need to print it if you haven't got a printer. Okay, so your steps to success are to explain why Christians have a Jesse tree, describe symbols on the Jesse tree, and retell the story of some of Jesus' ancestors. So that will be some of your reasons for why you think the pictures match the people. Okay, this is your date and walk. Don't forget to get that written nice and neatly in your book. I've been really impressed with your presentation so far, so keep that good work up. And then if you can leave me a learning bit at the end, that would be brilliant, so I know how well you've understood this work. Okay, what I'd like you to do is pause the video now and complete the work. When you're finished, you can come back and play again and I can go through some of those answers for you, okay? Right then, hopefully you've completed your work. We're just going to have a look at some of the answers that we've got. Let me see if I can find them for you. There's a PowerPoint that we can have a look at together to help us. Sorry, just took a minute to find it there. Okay, so let's just quickly look through some of these symbols so you can mark your work. So the Jesse tree symbols, the apple symbolizes Adam and Eve because they disobeyed God. He loved them and promised to send them a saviour. So they were told not to eat anything in the Garden of Eden, weren't they? And they actually ate an apple. Okay, the next one you might manage to do is the ark and the rainbow. And this one symbolises Noah. So God sent a flood. Noah built an ark to save his family and two of every kind of animal. God promised he would never again destroy the earth with a flood. And God put a rainbow in the sky to show his promise. And the next one is the star, and that symbolizes Abraham. God chose him to be the father of the Jewish people. God said he would have as many children as stars in the sky. So that one was Abraham. Then we've got Joseph, the coat of many colors. So this one symbolizes Joseph. Jacob had 12 sons, and his favorite son was Joseph. His brothers were very jealous of this. They sold him to Egypt as a slave. He became friends with the Pharaoh. He had stored crops so the Egyptians would not starve. And Jacob sent his sons to ask for food. Joseph forgave his brothers. The next symbol, then, this links to the Ten Commandments, so it symbolizes Moses. The Pharaoh made all Jewish people slaves. God sent Moses to lead his people to freedom, and God gave the Ten Commandments to Moses. Okay, the next symbol is the crown, and that symbolizes King David. David had been a shepherd boy. He grew up a wise and kind king, and God promised the Savior would come from King David's family. So you can see why he's an ancestor of Jesus. And the next is the hammer and the tools there. That symbolizes Joseph, the father of Jesus. Joseph was chosen by God to be the foster father of Jesus. He was a carpenter who loved Mary and Joseph. So a carpenter is somebody who works with wood. So if you remember back to our DT work, we were using saws in our woodwork, weren't we? Okay, and finally, we've got the flower, in particular a rose, and that symbolizes Mary, Jesus's mother. God chose Mary to be the mother of Jesus. Okay, well done, Year 4. Great RE work, and I look forward to seeing what you've been up to later.